Causal Inference is a Python package for causal analysis. It has different functionalities such as propensity score trimming, covariates matching, ordinary least squares treatment effects estimation, subclassification, and inverse probability weighting. In this tutorial, we will talk about how to do ordinary least squares treatment effects estimation. Other functionalities will be introduced in future tutorials. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import libraries. Firstly, let's install DAOI for dataset creation and causal inference for ordinary least squares treatment effects estimation. After the installation is completed, we can import the libraries. The datasets is imported from DAOI for dataset creation. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Causal model is imported from the causal inference package for ordinary least squares treatment effects estimation. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is one of the most referenced websites for data scientists. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me to keep providing free content, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free monthly posts for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. In step 2, we will create a synthetic dataset for the causal inference. Firstly, we set a random seed using np.random.seed to make the dataset reproducible. Then a dataset with the true causal impact of 10, 4 confounders, 10,000 samples, a binary treatment variable, and a continuous outcome variable is created. After that, we created a data frame for the data. In the data frame, the columns W0, W1, W2, and W3 are the 4 confounders. V0 is the treatment indicator, and Y is the outcome. Next, let's rename V0 to treatment, rename Y to outcome, and convert the Boolean values to 0 and 1. In step 3, we will initiate causal model and print the raw data summary statistics. Causal model takes 3 arguments. Y is the observed outcome. D is the treatment indicator. X is the covariates matrix. Causal model takes arrays as inputs, so dot values are used when reading the data. Causal.summaryStats prints out the raw summary statistics. The output shows that there are 2,269 units in the control group and 7,731 units in the treatment group. The average outcome for the treatment group is 13.94, and the average outcome for the control group is -2.191. So the raw difference between the treatment and the control group is 16.132, which is much higher than the actual treatment effect of 10. NORDIF is the standardized mean difference for covariates between the treatment group and the control group. Standardized mean differences greater than 0.1 means that the data is imbalanced between the treatment and the control group. We can see that most of the covariates have SMD greater than 0.1. In step 4, we will talk about how to measure the treatment effects using the ordinary least squares model. ESD Virals runs the ordinary least squares estimation. Changing the hyperparameter values changes the features in the model. Edge equals 0 only includes the treatment variable in the model, and it produces the raw differences between the treatment and the control group. Edge equals 1 includes the treatment variable and the covariates as the model predictors. In the actual model, the features are the demean values, meaning that the features are the covariate values minus the covariate mean. Edge equals 2 is the default value. It includes the treatment variable, the covariates, and the interactions between the treatment variable and the covariates as model predictors. Including the interaction terms imply that the treatment effect may differ across individuals. Causal.estimates prints out the treatment effect's estimation results. A TE is the average treatment effect. A TC is the average treatment effect on the control. A TT is the average treatment effect on the treated. To learn more about the average treatment effect, the average treatment effect on the control, the average treatment effect on the treated, and how the values are calculated, please check out my previous tutorial a TE versus KATE versus a TT versus a TC for causal inference. Comparing the ordinary least squares treatment effects results, we can see that edge equals 0 gives us the average treatment effects of 16.132, which is exactly the same as the raw differences we calculated in step 3. Edge equals 1 gives us the average treatment effects of 10, which is the same as the true causal impact. Edge equals 2 produces the true causal impact value of 10 for the average treatment effects, the average treatment effect on the control, and the average treatment effect on the treated. From the results, we can see that using the ordinary least squares to estimate the treatment effects greatly improved the accuracy of causal effect estimation. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about causal inference, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.